Hey guys, welcome to Surf and Show. I'm Noel Salas, and today is episode one of our How to Surf Better series, and the topic is bottom turns. Now this is gonna be fun. Sit back, get your favorite drink, enjoy the show. Now if you're new to our How to Surf Better tutorials, this is how it works. Each topic has multiple episodes in a series. That first episode in the series, we put out on YouTube, free of charge for all to enjoy. But as you go deeper into the series, it gets more advanced. Now we believe our content is best suited for that intermediate all the way to expert level surfers. Here's a good example. Our last topic was cutbacks. There's 5 episodes in that series. We took the first episode, put it on YouTube. Now to go deeper and unlock episodes 2 through 5, it's simple. You click the link below, you pledge $5, and you become a family patron. Now, what can you expect from us in each episode? We're gonna work on a couple of things. Look at some waves, break down proper technique. And I'm a huge fan of practical application. You're gonna work on those things while you're surfing. And then we have our Carver surf skates where we get out on the street and we start working on drills that are gonna ingrain new habits on the things we've been working on. Okay, enough about that. Let's look at a few waves and see what we're working on in this episode. Now doing a proper bottom turn really sets up the wave nicely so you can do whatever maneuver you want to do. Some of the things I want to focus on is getting a lot of speed, compressing and extending through my turns to generate that speed, and most of it starts from a solid bottom turn. Compressing in, extending out. It's not about the maneuver at the top, it's what's happening at the bottom that generates a lot of speed so you can be creative and do whatever you want to do. You can see it come off the bottom, nice little top turn, and when you do it right, you can gain speed on your rails and enjoy surfing top to bottom, and the more you practice your bottom turns, the more explosive you can be. Going straight to the bottom, nice bottom turn, squaring it straight up into the lip, compressing in my bottom turns, extending out. Let's slow it down and look at it again. As I get to my feet here, I'm looking straight to the bottom of the wave. Remember, the board goes wherever the head is looking. As I go to the bottom and I set this bottom turn, I want to point out that I have about 80% of my weight on my back leg and about 20% of my weight on my front leg. My head's already looking up at where I want to go. Let's zoom out. Here's my bullseye right here. This is where my eyes are looking, and the board's going to follow. Everything's on target. I'm compressing into this bottom turn. Let's check weight distribution now. I would say we're at like maybe a 60-40, relatively even, and I'm starting to get a lot of drive or speed through this turn. Let's look at nice and straight up right there. Now I'm looking straight down again. As I come down, I'm gonna start compressing into my bottom turn to start it over again. Here's my bullseye right here. And you can see my eyes are looking where I want to go. Let's finish it out. Nice and vertical here. Finishing it strong. Let's look at it again for you goofy footers. Going straight to the bottom, nice bottom turn, squaring it straight up into the lip, compressing in my bottom turns, extending out. Let's slow it down and look at it again. As I go to the bottom and I set this bottom turn, I want to point out that I have about 80% of my weight on my back leg and about 20% of my weight on my front leg. My head's already looking up at where I want to go. Let's zoom out. Here's my bullseye right here. This is where my eyes are looking, and the board's going to follow. Everything's on target. I'm compressing into this bottom turn. Let's check weight distribution now. I would say we're at like maybe a 60-40, relatively even, and I'm starting to get a lot of drive or speed through this turn. Let's look at nice and straight up right there. Now I'm looking straight down again. As I come down, I'm gonna start compressing into my bottom turn to start it over again. Here's my bullseye right here, and you can see my eyes are looking where I want to go. Let's finish it out. Nice and vertical here. Finishing it strong. As I go to the bottom, compress into that bottom turn, extend out. Nice top turn. to set the bottom turn and do it again. Let's slow it down a bit. As I drop in and go to the bottom, I'm compressing into this bottom turn. Now I'm starting to extend. I want to focus on this back arm is behind me. And as it goes back, it causes a twist or a coil up in my body. And when it uncoils, it's going to give me an increase in speed. I look down and I'm starting another bottom turn here. Here's my bullseye over here. And you can see my eyes are looking where I want to go. And I have a lot of whitewash to get around to get up and hit this bullseye again and do my foam climb. Let's undo that, finish it out, get nice and vertical, and finish strong. As I go to the bottom, compress into that bottom turn, extend out, nice top turn to set the bottom turn and do it again. Let's slow it down a bit. As I drop in and go to the bottom, I'm compressing into this bottom turn. Now I'm starting to extend. I want to focus on this back arm is behind me. And as it goes back, it causes a twist or a coil up in my body. And when it uncoils, it's going to give me an increase in speed. I look down and I'm starting another bottom turn here. Here's my bullseye over here. And you can see my eyes are looking where I want to go. And I have a lot of whitewash to get around to get up and hit this bullseye again and do my foam climb. Let's undo that, finish it out, get nice and vertical, and finish strong.
Now that we've looked at a couple waves and our focus is front side bottom turns, I want to talk about back foot placement. For me, it's imperative that your back foot is all the way back on the traction pad so you get nice, crisp bottom turns. As opposed to your foot being up here or even right here, you might be able to generate a lot of speed with your foot a little further up, but what you gain in speed, you sacrifice in pivot and the ability to sink the tail quick and get the board nice and vertical. So let's start with the wall behind me is my wave. This is front side for me. And the two waves we looked at, we got it from paddle in. I assessed the wave. I had time to go to the bottom, set a bottom turn, look up, pick my spot, get vertical, and then go to the bottom and do it again. Not every wave's like that. Sometimes the wave's really fast. So we'll paddle in an angle, get to our feet, get a couple pumps, then we go to the bottom. Set our bottom turn, and then we do our maneuver. The bottom turn is the most important thing in surfing because it sets up the whole wave. And it's the key to every good maneuver. Now, before I go into demonstrating a bottom turn, I want to talk about the three other topics we've been working on. Remember, we've been talking about generating speed down the line, compressing and extending, right? Then we went into generating speed rail to rail, right? Compressing in, extending out. Compressing in, extending out. And that's how we're getting our speed. And then our last topic's been cutbacks. And one of the main things I want to focus on is on a cutback, when we're initiating at the top, we take our chin to our shoulder and we start with the head and everything comes around and follows what the head's doing. Now I want to take a little bit from all the three other topics and I want to put them together and we're going to go into the bottom turn. One of the major things that we'll always be working on is compressing, extending, and looking, being deliberate, that where we look, the board will follow. Let me explain how this works on the bottom turn. So I drop in, I compress into my bottom turn, because as I'm compressing, I'm gaining speed. Then as I go to the bottom and I'm all the way at the bottom, my weight transfer is more like 80-20, right? And I start to look up at where I want to go next in my maneuver. So when I start to look up, did you see how naturally my shoulders opened to this location right here? And that causes a twist. And that twist is gonna create coil. So as I look up, I'm here. Now, I haven't mentioned toe pressure, but the toe pressure is pretty intense. I'm gripping my traction pad with my toes. And as I come here, I'm compressing and if I have to hold it, I can. And then I come up here and then you see this shoulder, how far back it is? That's the coil or twist I'm talking about. And then I can get up in here and do the turn. Now, as I come out of that turn, I'm looking down, I'm compressing in, I hit the bottom turn. And as I go into here, I'm starting to look up to do my second vertical turn. Now, it doesn't have to be vertical, guys. That's just the ways we look at it. And that's the extreme of going to the bottom, really settling down, compressing in, looking up, and creating that coil and then doing that turn. It could be that you're going to the bottom to do your bottom turn and it might not be as severe as the ones I'm talking about. But when we hit a bottom turn and then you want to do a cutback, it's important. Compress in, come in here, extend out. So there's a weight shift. It might start 80-20 on the big bottom turn, right? But as I come around, I'm starting to shift my weight forward so I can gain speed through that turn. Let's get out on our carvers and start working on some drills together. Now, as I come towards you, I'm gonna show you guys my body being pretty upright, and I'm twisting shoulders and hips and I'm generating speed. Then I'm gonna start compressing and extending while twisting, and that's gonna be a huge part of what you should be feeling when you go into your bottom turn. We compress in and we extend out. And when we extend, you're gonna feel that twist. That twist is what we're working on. So we can create coil, extend out of that bottom turn, and generate speed. Here we go. So feet are set, side to side. No body movement in compressing and extending. Now I'm gonna implement that. Look at it now. You see that twist? That's what we're after. So today I got my Rad Ripper, C7 truck and back truck both set to medium. The cones are set. This is the arc of my bottom turn. I have a cone over there. Let me show you what we're gonna do. I'm gonna come from down the street. I'm gonna hit this bottom turn right here. And the idea is to compress in, and then I wanna feel the twist, and I wanna extend out, and I wanna hit that next turn with a lot of speed. All right, so let's count off our cones. We're gonna go five across. 1, 2, 4, 5. I want you to drop a cone. And then we're going 3 from here to here. 1, 2, 3. Drop a cone. And the same here. 1, 2, 3. Drop a cone. Now I want to get to that cone. So let's just count it off. 1, 2, 3, 8, 9. Drop a cone. And then I want to go 9 across. 1, 2, 8, 9. Drop a cone. So now we're gonna pick up this cone, put it over here, and we're set. All right, couple pumps. Let's work for speed here. Back foot's all the way back. I'm going to the bottom, I'm looking to the bottom. I'm compressing in, extending out, hitting my top turn hard. Now this time, guys, I'm gonna focus on 80-20 weight and feeling the toe pressure as I hit this bottom turn, extend out, hit my top turn hard. As you continue to work on this particular drill, when you come down here, I want you to look down because the board's gonna follow where you're looking. And when you get to here in your bottom turn, remember to look up. That's gonna open the shoulders and start the twist, right? Compress in, extend out. And I also want you to feel the toe pressure on your trailing foot as you push. That's what's gonna make it most like surfing.
Well, guys, I hope you enjoyed episode 1 on bottom turns. We're working on episode 2, and you've got your homework cut out for you. Whether you're out surfing or carving on your surf skates, ingrain these new habits and do some solid bottom turns. Until next time, we'll see you in the water. Bye-bye.